Good morning, Esther's Crown. Good day, God's blessings, God's richest blessings. Good day, His promises. Every day, new mercies. Every day, opportunities. Open heavens. Every day, walking one with Him. He said He will never leave or forsake us. He is ever present. Our help in our present time of need, that's who He is, greater in us than greater than any spirit, any person, anything in this earth. Greater is He. Yep, we give honor to the Lord, to one another. I'm leaning in. Blessings. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Hallelujah. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Out of our bellies shall flow rivers of life. Life change. Life words. Life-giving, life-givers, givers of life, offsprings of the Lord. Yes, generational blessings, generational soldiers. That's who we are. Increase to each one of us. Good morning, God's blessings. Good day. Thank you. Thank you for agreement and prayer. Still leaning in. Leaning over the side of a recliner. I like to gather in the living room here in hopes that the dogs and kitties will keep it calm a little bit. I do want to get going because I've got the one dog, which you all know by now. We've made friends on here. He's actually calm right now, so he deals with a lot of anxiety. I pray for him all the time, but he's actually calm, so we want to get the prayer going, get our batteries started while we have time for that. So thank you so much. Blessings. Thank you for your prayers, for partnering, for fellowship, for us being able to come together in agreement. So I was thinking of this story with Jesus. We're still in Matthew. I'm going to stay there until he leads us into another book or some other promises and blessings. But it pertains to forgiveness and healing. A lot of times I say to people, you know, the healing that you desire is in that place of forgiveness. And I'm not just saying only in forgiveness, but forgiveness. Like when we come into salvation and we are forgiven, when we say, forgive me, Lord, and we come into that place, there's so much healing that takes place into being born again just right there. And that healing continues on. Now, I can remember in times in my life where I just cry to be forgiven or cry to forgive somebody. And when I came out of that place, like a area of my soul was mended, or like that thought process of the imaginations and the way I thought about a certain situation had changed and it wasn't there anymore. I was like, oh my gosh, it's healing. And even in the body, there's been times when I call them stress pains, but when we're upset with somebody or somebody's upset with us, a little pain or something in our body, well, that's been healed when forgiveness came. So forgiveness and healing are hand in hand. Yes, good morning, God's blessings. I'm leaning in. We're getting ready to pray. While it's quiet. While it's quiet. I'm like in the den of the animals, if you know what I mean. I'm in the animal den. All right. So here we go. Let's this is what I wanted to go into, chapter 9 of Matthew. Christ cures the palsy. And here, where they were troubled because he ate with publicans and sinners, but here, verse 1. And he entered into a ship and passed over and came into his own city. And behold, they brought to him a man sick of palsy, lying on a bed. And Jesus, seeing their faith, said unto the sick with palsy, Son, be of good cheer, your sins be forgiven you. And behold, certain of the scribes said within themselves, This man blasphemes. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, Wherefore do you think with this evil in your hearts? For whether it is easier to say, Your sins are forgiven thee, or to say, Arise and walk. But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. Then he said to the sick of the sick man with the palsy, Arise, take up your bed, and go unto your house. So, Father, we thank you today, one, for the forgiveness that you offer us, new mercies every day, thoughts, actions, words, just things that we go through from the sun up to the sundown. The things that we deal with within our relationships with one another, with the task at hand, just all of it, God, We do need forgiveness. So here, you said, which is easier? And you always offer your hand of forgiveness. So Father, today we agree that a mighty outpouring of your loving kindness, your forgiveness, your mercy, it'll just overflow us, just like a bucket pouring out, that this healing forgiveness would just pour over every area of us, from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet, and that we can say it's well with us, that we can receive that healing, just as you remove palsy from him, God, and you cause blind eyes to open and deaf ears to hear, and physical ailments, the legs not even being able to walk, and suddenly standing at the feet. God, you brought healing to the issue of blood. The forgiveness you brought, the healing you forgot, brought. Show us today it's for us, God. Today, that there would be an agreement of faith, an agreement of belief, that wherever there's an ache in our body or a pain or an unforgiving thought or an unrecognized sin or a regret, anything that's just lying subtle or dormant or not dealt with, we say, come in by the grace of who you are. You said by your stripes we were, which means we are always healed, ever present. Your purpose for coming to this earth was to save, to rescue, to heal, to deliver, to show us your kindness. For it is the goodness that draws us to this place of repentance. Today, we stand in agreement that you're a good God, that your name is great, that you are worthy of great praise, God. We stand in honor of all that you've done. We say thank you for salvation. Thank you for fellowship. Thank you for your word, the ministry of the written word, alive in the blood, alive in the covenant, word made flesh, in agreement in our soul, spirit, body, mind, and will, our wills being given over to you. Today we say yes to surrender. We stand in the gap for every distant relative, every distant friend, all those that stand estranged or off in the distance from the cross, those mockers and scoffers, evil workers, God. We say vengeance from you to the ones that need to be vindicated. Victor mine, victor's crowns. You said, wear the victor's crown, wear the victor's. Behold, I've placed on you a crown, crown of life. As we overcome temptation, we receive this crown, God, crown that cannot be stole or wore away, or, you know, just ruined, God, the crown that remains, crown of life, unto the glory of who you are. Fill us with faith today, boldness, courage, and confidence, new beginnings, fresh starts. Cause our enemies to be at peace with us, God. Silence those that want to speak against us or about us in ways that aren't true, Lord Jesus, even in ways that are. Your mercy supersedes their judgment. Your mercy triumphs in our lives, in our hearts, in our loved ones. This nation, we stand in agreement for the United States of America. And we say, yes, that you love America, that America is as the apple of your eye, God. That even through fornication and lies and you know, deceptive governments, God, and all the evil, you still haven't turned your back. You still remain faithful because you said you change not. You're faithful to our forefathers. You're faithful to your word, to those that stepped out and declared it for you. You remain steadfast over your promises. You change not, God. Remind us of that as we stand in a fallen world and in a place, God, where panic and anxiety and fear and depression and greed and all this evil and self-hatred and sinful natures and all this is going, God, we pray you speak louder, that your servants, that your laborers, your sons and daughters and children, the newborns, the ones that are just born again, that declaration will come out of our mouths about who you are. We won't shrink back. We won't deny you, God. Give us that courage that only comes from you. As you spoke it to Joshua, you said only out of the heart of who you are, out of the power of all you are, God, you said to Joshua, only be strong, only be courageous, be this way. And you kept reminding him that's just how good you are, that you remind us, blessed are you when you hunger and thirst after righteousness. Blessed are you when you become a peacemaker. Blessed are you when you're pure, when your heart is creating me, God. Come in and flood out those areas. If there be any pride working in my flesh, God, in our flesh, God, if there be anything there, come in. Birth humility out of brokenness. Flood us with all that you are. We agree today. We need you. We confess Jesus as Lord. We confess our shortcomings and failures. We say, God, with you, everything's is possible. With us, impossible, but with you, possible. We say that today. With us, the impossible presents itself every morning. But as we step into this faith walk, this faith talk, prayer, we're strengthened one with another. You said, Peter, go strengthen your brothers. When your obedience has come full circle, go and be the light, be the truth, speak the love, declare the promises. Do you love me? 3 times over and 100 times full return. Yes, Lord. Yes, we love you. Thank you for your precious gifts. Thank you for hearing our cries, answering prayers, signs, miracles, wonders, open heavens. Yes, Lord. Repentance to salvation being the most awesome prayer need, awesome miracles when that heart's been converted, when that hardened heart is suddenly softened under the weight of your word, under the ministry of your presence and your angels. Send forth your angels in all the earth, around our vehicles, around our homes, around our families, churches, our government. Send your angels into the highways and byways, the marketplaces, God, the fields, Lord Jesus, into every place in the earth, angels on assignment where people are facing persecutions, mission fields, prisons, hospitals, courthouses, classrooms. Oh, Jesus, all over, send them, Lord. Reigning angels in the earth, sending them forth. We're in agreement with heaven. You said you'd send a multitude of angels. You send a multitude, God. Hallelujah. Send forth your promises. Raise them up, God, out of the caves. Raise them up out of the woods, God. Raise them up. Bring recovery to the homeless, to the heartless, to the naked, to the ones that need food. God, may no belly in this earth, no belly, creature, creation, small, young, old, no belly go hungry, God. The wealth of this earth is too great for hunger, Lord Jesus. Give us the wisdom. Pour into us ideas. Suddenly the mind being renewed, the hearts being generous, God. Pour it out, Father, the wealth of the wicked being stored up for the causes of your goodness, of your heartbeat towards all of your creation. We agree with heaven today. We say yes and amen. We say yes and amen to your promises, God. We agree. Spirit of truth, come, flood our hearts, single-minded to you, no divisions. God, may our differences of opinions not be a spirit of division. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the diversity of gifts, of callings, of offices. Even in the denominations that think differently, may there be unity in agreement to what your word has said, to what you've declared, to who you are, God. May we not dismantle the life of who you are, the power of your word, the presence of your holiness. Holy Spirit, Spirit of truth, vindicator, judge, righteous judge, almighty Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. Worthy Jesus, we lift up one another's prayer needs. We lift up each other's relationships, our relatives, our neighbors, on the job. God, we say favor going in and favor going out. Open doors of you and close that are not of you. We give you access. We give you permission. We open ourselves in full surrender today. Right now, me and Esther's Crown, our friends, your family of faith, in agreement for every relative. For every circumstance and situation, the nations represented here, we stand in agreement for every nation. Yes, Lord, we say, have your way. Let it be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day daily bread in the area of natural substance and supernatural. May the increase come to us in our households, God. Spiritual children being blessed, being the head and not the tail. Our sons and daughters recovering and dreaming dreams and visions coming out, God. We need a stand that goes beyond time and space, circumstance and situation. A stand united where we say yes to the Ten Commandments, not dismissing them anymore, but living them, fulfilled in us, where goodness just generates through us as a fruit. Goodness and kindness just coming through our pores from the supernatural fruit of who you are in our life. Life changers, yes. Breath carriers, hallelujah. Breathing life. Wherever we go, words of life, give us the tongue of the learned, the ears that hear, the eyes that see. We want to walk one with you. Right now, we lay down the filthy garments. We refuse to call this place of glory anything less than who you are, one with you. Burning bush, voice in the wilderness, behold, the clouds opening up and the voice coming forth, my son in whom I'm well pleased. Yes, Lord, we say yes, Father. We say to the message of the cross and the message of the blood covenant, it is finished. Father, teach us how to walk in the finished work, God. Sons and daughters, manifested glory, truth keepers. Yes, warriors on a mission, God. Warriors. Yes, God, heavenly kingdom bound here in this earth, the keys, the righteousness, the peace, the joy, manifesting kingdom order, manifesting life with you eternal right here, Father, knowing that our light affliction is temporary. It's only for a moment, God, showing us that whatever we're willful to go through, when we go through it with you, there's this awesome recovery. There's this place, Lord Jesus, where things are just settled and where renewal and revival comes to the soul. Hallelujah. Renew and revive our soul from the youngest to the oldest, the smallest to the largest, the smallest to the greatest, the poorest to the richest, from that little smallest creature on up into the giant of the jungle, God. Have your way, Father, in the plants. You said everything in the earth to praise you, God. Right now, Father, the trees. Teach us how to look at the streams of the water and identify ourselves with your creation, with what you said about the streams, how you said streams of life, how we're planted right there, that rivers, that truth would prevail, that not one would be plucked from your hand, that you'd raise us up in the last day, that you would shine your glory, that a remnant would come forth, that we would have the seal of the Holy Spirit in our foreheads, that we would be identified with you, God. Revelation of Jesus. Lord, bring your revelation, your revealing, from the crown on down, inside and out. Every hair, every fiber, every bit of our being, organs being restored, creative miracles to replacement, body parts, God. Everything you said, aches and pains being gone in the sound of heaven. Yes, Lord. Sight restored, ears popping open and being clear. Yes, infection gone out of the body. Infection, any infectionary areas of infection right now, healed in Jesus' name, made whole, entire, complete, blood, body, immune system, every bit of us, joint, marrow, bones, yes, Lord, skin conditions, the skin of God, the life of the flesh in glory to what he said about it, skin conditions healed, praise you. Hallelujah. You're so good to us. So good. Provision suddenly is coming into our hands. Enough to eat. Bills being paid. Yes, Lord. More than enough. Sowing into you, God. Sending our first fruits into the ground where you show us to send it to, God. Being mindful of the things that belong to you. A generation that's pure. A generation that seeks your face. Jacob carriers, a generation that walks in the likeness of Abraham, filled with faith, righteousness being restored in the faith walkers of unity with you, God. Yes, Jesus, we say yes. Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you for your covenant friendship, fellowship. Thank you, Abba, for knowing that we were going to need a comforter, for not leaving us without. For once the payment, the price was paid, you sent this precious gift, to say this is the way you should go. For those who walk in the Spirit, we don't fulfill the deeds of the flesh, the lust of this life, the worldly, ungodly things, denying the power thereof, even the power of their influence, saying, no, I don't think so. That's not for my house. No, we're not going to do that around here. No, I think we'll glorify God in this house, giving honor to whom honor is due. God, I pray respect come back to the earth, God. Respect, especially for our elderly, our seniors, our military officers, those front row workers, God, those that go into places that where their heart races, where they're not sure if they're going to go home. God, may the households be restored and recovered and healing come where there's been loss or emptiness or devastation, God. Every heart being on the mend. Every heart, God, you said praying for all the saints, petitions for all of them, whether we knew them or not. Heaven has a purpose that earth needs to know about. Today we agree with heaven. We say yes to heaven. God, there's things we will never know about that you've put on the heart of somebody else, or that only you and the Trinity and the heavens know about. Today, as intercessors, we agree. We agree. Unknown things, we agree. Unrecognized things, we agree. We agree with your will. We agree with your word. We agree with your spirit. We agree with heaven and this earth. God, whether it's the time of the mark or it's the time of new beginnings, we say yes. Comfort those who mourn. Revive those who are dry and lay. This is your word, God. You said speak to those bones. You said talk to that sea. You said put what's in your hand and reach it out and tell it shall separate. It shall be divided, God. You said speak to the rock and say to it, give my people some water. Oh, Jesus, if we understood your word. If we understood there in the jail cell, in the place of persecution, suddenly the chains fell off and the doors flew open. Then nothing was locked. And to that night, in that midnight place, souls were saved unto the promise of salvation, the gift, for you so loved that you gave. And you keep on giving an outpouring today of your generous spirit of new life. Revival hope. Yes, God, may we nest with you. If any one of us are nesting, may it be with you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for being with each one of us, with this generation. You would never forsake us. Show us how to lean in to hear what it is you'd say, to know the secrets, to actually understand how you feel about it. We want to know you more. We want you to reveal to us who you are, God. Leaders being called godly, representing holiness, understanding, being brought to teachers and parents and families, and respect, God. That's just it. Respect. Respect being right there in the womb of delivery for this generation, God. Respect, Lord Jesus. Leaders rising up and leading in a such a way that it just welcomes in a respect response. Knowing you are revealing to the churches and body that welcomes in an honor and reverence to you as God. We love you, Father. You're worthy. Bless everything that we put our hands to. Bless what belongs to us, God. Your merciful grace overshadowing all of us and everything that is ours. All that you've called us to do, birth us in this earth into the callings and the purposes and plans that you have. Yes, Lord, we say yes. Our neighbors, our families, the churches, your spirit prevailing. It's who you are, God. Surely goodness and mercy following us and us dwelling in your house. Here, God, in there. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you. Thank you. Settle it. Thank you for hearing all of us, God. Over all of it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Who we pray for our enemies right now, those that persecute, those that speak evil, those that are ill-willed, those that don't know God. Teach our hearts that a lot of times the things that come at us are from a place of ignorance, of not knowing. God, if it's malice, show us it's malice. But if it's just ignorance, give us the peace and the patience and the fruit to endure, to be steadfast in your walk and your character and nature, to deal with things, God. We want to be who we're called to be on this side of every debate, every opinion, every argument, every passionate pursuit. We want to be on this side with you, where we're doing what we're called to do, where we understand what that means, God. Fill us with faith today. God, teach us how to exercise. Open us up to more, Lord Jesus. Show us what our part is so we can do it. We can do it gracefully and willingly and accurately and precisely. If we don't know God, we can't do it. Open up our understanding, as Paul prayed, that the eyes of their understanding would be enlightened, that our eyes would be enlightened, the understanding within us that we may know the truth, what is the glory and calling and high price. Thank you, God, for all that you're doing in our hearts and the hearts of our loved ones. Thank you, Jesus. And all the earth, we say yes. We say have your way. We agree today. Yes, we do. New day, new week. Fresh start, new mercies, compassions that fail not, forgiveness being ever present, the cross always there, the blood speaking, the blood, the DNA of Christ, the blood speaks still today. There's life in the blood. There's newness of purpose. There's healing. There's forgiveness, God. Salvation, wanderers coming home, prodigals coming to their right mind. Remembering strays, seeing the path, the narrow, and taking its course. Yes, Lord. Orphans and widows restored, revived. Yes, Lord. May each and every person today feel special and know that they're special. Feel accepted and know that they're accepted. Feel belonging and know that they belong. Right now, we send out this open communication in the spirit, this cry, this calling, that every place that has a feeling or a thought of insignificance would be replaced today with belonging. Right now, yes, Lord, every place in this earth that seems insignificant, seems belittled, seems lower than, seems not wanted, unwanted, we speak truth. We speak truth right now into every bit of the earth that God so loved, and everything that he created, he said, very good. You have purpose. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah and praise. You are worthy. We give you this day, our hearts. Thank you, Father. All of it, God. Every creature, every person, unborn babies, seniors taking their last breath, we say yes to all of it. Every worker in the field, every person on the job, all of your creation, We say, have your way. Just have your way, God. Whatever it is, we don't even have to know about it. The things you know about, we just agree. We agree. You said that. You said if any two of you agree, we agree right now with you and your purposes, your word and your spirit, your plans with heaven. Yes. Hallelujah. Over all of it. And we settle it today in your name, in your spirit. We settle it. We thank you for hearing us. We thank you for answers. We thank you for the miracles coming forth. Bodies healed, minds renewed, souls revived, spirits born again. We thank you, God, for daily bread, provision increase, for unexpectedlies, for suddenlies. And we're not talking about anything negative. We're talking about the glory cloud, not a dark cloud. The protection of grace, the pillar by night, the way maker, the way made for each one, forgiveness abounding and healing coming forth. That's what we opened up with. Matthew, the book of the story of which is easier to say, scribes. What's easier? Forgiveness of sins today and healings of bodies in the mighty name of Jesus across this earth and in this prayer group. Miracles in this prayer group right now. Miracles. Answers, suddenlies, unexpected, the grace and glory of God prevailing through it all. In Jesus' almighty name, precious are your thoughts towards us, God. Yes, they are. What the enemy means for harm to Lord Jesus, we pray that turnaround. That turnaround in Jesus' name, and whatever schemes he's trying to scheme up, that they fall to the ground right now. Angels come and camp around all that's us, not leaving, not moving, fighting and warring against the unseen things and unseen circumstances as God's will prevails and comes forth. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless each and every one in this earth. You are worthy. Across the earth, God, you are worthy. Thank you, Jesus. I just pray you settle this, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Over all of it, God. North, south, east, and west. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, friend of God's. Thank you, friends. Thank you, calling it forth. Yes, Lord. In agreement, God. In agreement. That's what we're doing. We're agreeing with you. Not praying our own will. Thy will be done. In earth, yes, this day, thy will be done. In earth as it is in heaven. Thy will, yes. Thy will. Is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Your word, God. Word walkers, God. Word keepers, Jesus. Clear it all out, God. Clear it all out. Every bit of it, Jesus. In all the earth. Every bit of our existence, God, belonging to you. No fear, no isolation, no confusion, no witchcraft, no wantonness, warring and wrestling, none of that, God, just you and us, that place, that footstep place, God. Generation of boldness, thank you, God. Be with our friends and family as they travel and make decisions and purchases and changes and growth. Be with them, God. Show yourself mighty, Father, over it all. It's who you are, God. Hallelujah, it's who you are. Recompense to each one, God. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, God's blessings. Have a blessed, Jesus-filled, Holy Ghost, Word of God-filled day. May His presence be ever known to you, before you, behind you, around you. His Word, true and tried over you, and angels around everything, everything that's us, protected. Yes, God. Keep us, Lord. All right. Love you. God bless. Bye-bye.